guys, so I didn't mention this last episode or point this out, but I do have a new backdrop going this week. Took a little bit of time to just kind of show off my masshole nature, my townie bias, if you will, which hopefully won't show in any of these. But just a little bit about me. Huge Pats fan. Grow up watching them. Been on the season ticket wait list for about 6 years now, and I think I still have another 10 to go because that's how New England fans are. But so anyway, we're going to talk about Alvin Kamara now. And so he finishes the running back 9 overall last year and 8 in points per game. And it felt like he had a really down year because he did, because you paid up for this guy. He was probably a top 4 pick in your draft and he didn't live up to what you were hoping for. But what I'm going to tell you to do is pick up Alvin Kamara's stats in 2019 and just look at his 16 game pace, because in 4 major categories, attempts, rushing yards, targets, and receptions, his 16-game pace in 2019 was higher than any other season that he's had. And we all know with Kamara in the past, his value has been found in his efficiency. But 2019, he was starting to get some of that volume too, and that felt good when you look back at the year. And the reason why he didn't feel good overall is because of his touchdown production. He only had six touchdowns in all of 2019, which made him feel like a bust. He had 13 touchdowns in 17 and 18 touchdowns in 2018. So these 6 touchdowns in 2019 was a major disappointment. But he's still in an explosive New Orleans offense that added Emmanuel Sanders. I think he's really going to bounce back into these double-digit touchdowns in 2020, and I think he could be upwards of 15 once again. I think if you draft him, you won't be disappointed. I think you're also going to see some of his efficiency come back in the receiving game. In 17 and 18, he averaged 8.8 and 10.2 yards per reception, respectively, and only 6.6 in 2020. So I think part of that was due to his high ankle sprain. If you look back to my Saquon Barkley episode, you can hear me talk about the impact of high ankle sprains on running backs. But I think between the recovery of the ankle, the regression, and a positive nature for his touchdowns in 2020, and the increase in volume that he saw in 2019, Alvin Kamara is gonna, I have him above Dalvin Cook here, and I think he's gonna finish as a top 4 running back, and I think we all know that if he does ball out, he does have the ceiling to finish as a top 2 RB.